Well, I take the view that the you know, the normal discussion of the origin of life is the materialist framework is taken for granted, that here's this entire unconscious universe, stars, galaxies, planets, rock, totally unconscious, totally dead, and then miraculously or by chance, here on Earth, the first life appears and has the potential to become us. Well, a bit like Geshe Namdak, I don't really accept that view that the whole universe is totally unconscious to start with. And like Geshe Namdak, I think that if there are other planets where life has already evolved, then by morphic resonance there could be influences to this planet, and evolution on this planet could be shaped by influences from others. But that pushes the problem back to other planets and other forms of life, and you could argue that given the Big Bang theory of the universe, at one stage there were no planets, so the Big Bang was billions of degrees centigrade, there was not even atoms, it was too hot for atoms or even plasma. So there must have been the first life somewhere, even if it wasn't here. But I don't take the view that the whole universe is unconscious, you see. I think that if we take the view that the entire universe might have a kind of mind or consciousness, and a galaxy might have a mind or consciousness, a solar system might have a mind or consciousness, a planet might have a mind or consciousness, and therefore when the first life appears on that planet, it's not as if consciousness has come from nowhere, from total unconsciousness, but it's coming into being within a larger, more coherent conscious system, and which may play a role, a creative role, in the emergence of life within it. So in the case of the Earth, if we take the view that Gaia, the Earth, is a living organism, that there was a kind of not just rock, but also oceans and swirling currents and clouds and atmosphere and hydrothermal vents and clay that sort of dried up and then during the seasons and got wet again, all sorts of changing conditions that might have been allowed for the emergence of life within Gaia, that the mind of Gaia may have played a role in that emergence of life. We don't necessarily have to explain it in terms of a bottom-up emergence from mere inorganic or simple organic chemicals to more complex ones. The usual view is this bottom-up view. But actually, even within modern physics, there's a top-down view. I mean, the gravitational field is a top-down field that includes everything in the universe. It doesn't emerge gradually from bottom-up from particles of matter. It's there from the beginning. And according to superstring theory, there was an initial unified field of all nature with 10 dimensions or 11 in brain theory or M theory. And that these underwent a kind of splitting, these fields of nature split up, gravity separated from electromagnetism, but originally it was one combined field. And that these top-down fields have shaped the universe from the large to the small. So it's not all from the small to the large. And if these overarching organizing fields have a conscious element to them, then we have a kind of interaction between the small and the large, which puts that problem in a different light. It doesn't explain it. It doesn't give us any sense of detail as to how the first life happened. But it suggests that we don't necessarily have to look for the origin of life in purely blind inorganic matter and random collisions of atoms.
Mm.